station on Space to Ground.
Welcome to Space to Ground. I'm Catherine Clayton. This week, the Expedition 64 crew says farewell. There's preparations for the SpaceX Crew 2 launch, and science just right for Earth Day. After the arrival of NASA astronaut Mark Vanderheide and Roscosmos cosmonauts Oleg Novitsky and Pyotr Dubrov last week, the Expedition 64 crew can now return home. NASA astronaut Kate Rubins, along with Sergei Kuzvershkov and Sergei Ryshkov of Roscosmos, will undock from the station this week, marking the end of Expedition 64. During this transition, ISS command will change from Sergei Ryshkov to NASA astronaut Shannon Walker. Shannon will remain in command until the end of April, when she will join astronauts Mike Hopkins and Victor Glover, along with JAXA astronaut Suichi Noguchi, to return to Earth. The upcoming Crew 2 launch will bring four new crew members to the International Space Station. The SpaceX Crew 2 mission is ready to travel to the ISS and will be launching on April 22nd. The flight will mark the second flight of the Crew Dragon Endeavour to the station and will carry NASA astronauts Shane Kimbrough and Megan MacArthur, JAXA astronaut Aki Yoshide, and ESA astronaut Thomas Pesquet. Also be sure to listen to the latest episode of Houston We Have a Podcast. The four Dragon crew members, Shane, Megan, Aki, and Thomas, sat down for a special pre-launch interview. April 22nd is also Earth Day, and a science facility on the ISS is answering important questions about how hard our planet is working for us. The Orbiting Carbon Observatory 3, or OCO3, is a sensor that uses sunlight reflections through the atmosphere to measure carbon dioxide variations in the atmosphere at any given time for a specific location. Plants and the ocean remove approximately half of the human carbon dioxide emissions each year, but that percentage can vary. Launched in 2019, the observatory is designed to help determine the causes of that variation. Due to the ISS orbital path, OCO3 will pass over forests, crop areas, cities, and power plants. This will provide a detailed picture of atmospheric carbon dioxide levels across the planet. That's Space to Ground for this week. Thanks for watching, and we'll see you next week.
Subscribe for more space.